What's up, YouTube? Welcome back. That clip you just seen took place post this project. So today, we are going to be removing this vinyl strip from my 2002 Dodge Dakota. Issues we're running into right here, a little bit of peeling. These pillar strips, or vinyl, I don't even know what to call it really, come stock on this particular truck. This is a sport model Dakota, 2002 Dodge Dakota, that comes standard on a sport, for instance. This Dodge especially run this vinyl strip or a version of this vinyl strip on a lot of their years of their Dakotas, their Rams, some of their cars, SUVs. This is basically something to kind of break up the body lines between the windows and all that. You'll see it on extended cabs like this, for instance. You'll see them on four doors especially. They've got this vinyl strip between the front door and the back door. But as you can see, the issue we were running into up there, that is why we are removing ours. But I have seen in the past extreme cases of this where this is actually cracked all the way down through here, making all of this vinyl very brittle. You can take your hand and almost scrape it off with your hand. Ours is not that extreme at the moment. We're going to go ahead and remove it mainly to take care of that issue. But maybe I think I'm going to like the way it looks. Done a little research on it, and I think I'm going to like the way it looks without the strips. So, two birds, one stone, fixing a problem and getting a benefit that we may enjoy a little bit better. So, what we're going to be using to remove this thing is this very old, very worn out heat gun to heat up the strip, peel it off. And then once we get it off, we may have to use some adhesive remover, depending what is left behind. I have in the past had to do that. Not every time. One door, I had an instance where one door on another truck we had, we removed it, had a little bit of adhesive on it. The next one we did on the other side, removed it completely clean, nothing left behind. So this, we'll see how it goes. I'm hoping we don't have to use the adhesive remover, but if we do, that's not a big deal. I've got some stuff over there on the shelf we can use. The only other thing that you may need to watch for when you're doing this is having to remove any sort of trim pieces that may be holding down the edge of this pillar strip. Ours, I think I'm going to be able to pull back this, bring the wind down, pull back this weather strip here, and take the end of this one up so we can get up under here and get a hold of it and get it out of there. So that's about all we're going to need for this project. So without further ado, we'll get started on this. We'll be right back. Okay, so just a little bit of an update. Here we are. It's one of the not bad cases I've seen, but it's definitely not coming off in one piece. So that tells me right there that that stuff was getting very brittle. We may be very close, may have been very close to it cracking, kind of like what we were talking about at the beginning of the video. So we're going to try a different approach. We're going to try to heat it up a little bit and use this putty knife. Try to get up under it a little better. That may work a little bit better rather than trying to use our fingers. So keep going here. All right, guys, update. That was not easy at all, but we were able to remove it. As you can see here, we do have some residue or adhesive left behind. Yeah, there it is. So we are going to have to use an adhesive remover product. Tips for removing that thing. I found that getting it extremely, extremely hot makes that makes it a little more pliable to get it off. In this particular instance, I think that that vinyl was on its way out. I was going to start seeing some issues. Hence the little spot at the top that we seen right before we started this. Why that happened, because it was becoming brittle. It was all very brittle, and I think if a guy was to not try to save the paint underneath of it, you could take something like something pretty coarse and get it off. But whereas I'm trying to save my paint in this particular instance, I really couldn't go that route, so I had to take it slow and just pick at it pretty much. There's no really other good way. I did use a putty knife a little bit, try to get some of the edge out, and here as well. So we got it out, it worked. Now we will take some adhesive remover to try to get this adhesive off. Okay, I am using a goof off product here. It does say for use on fully cured varnish, oil-based paint surfaces, metals, glass, brick, wood, concrete, grout, fiberglass, and hand tools. It does say down here, always test on inconspicuous areas first. Damages many plastics, worn vinyl floors, and some automotive paints. From my experience, I have seen if you dump it like on a hood or something and was to leave it there, let it soak in, that's where you might have some issues. But what we're gonna do, we're gonna dab it with a shop towel, try to get it on the adhesive, not let it sit on there very long. I find success in that. So I think if we do it this way, we should be able to get something off. When you got what you want, baby, I should All right, guys, just a quick little update. We got what we could with the goof off. Dabbed it on there, let it sit a little bit, wiped it off. Did that a couple different times, and it got a lot of the adhesive off, but we're still struggling with it just a little bit. So what I'm actually going to do tomorrow is go get 3M makes an adhesive stripper wheel to put on the end of a power drill. We're going to actually go get one of those. I had one in the past. I kind of wore it out, so we're going to get a new one before we tackle this. But roll up the window, take a look. So basically what we're dealing with, we have the majority of it. It's just a little sticky there, and I don't know if you can see up through the light there, see the adhesive. But we did get the a bulk of it with the goof off, but we're gonna go try to get one of those wheels taken care of. So I will see you tomorrow, and we will get this thing knocked out, get going on the other side. And it's the next day. What up, guys? Same hoodie, different hat. What we picked up today, like we said, was this adhesive remover tool. Stripper wheel is what they call it. Stuck it on the end of a drill. We're going to take it to that, try to get the adhesive off of it. But we picked up that and a lifeline. And trying to make it through our projects. So, without further ado, we're going to get right on this, get this adhesive off so we can move over to the other side and get started on it. After quite a bit of work, we beat it. All the adhesive is removed from our B pillar. The only thing that we are going to have to do in this instance, right here, we've got a weather strip that's just stuck on with some sticky 3M, I don't even know what they call it. I've got some over there. But anyway, it's just a sticky adhesive for our automotive adhesive behind it. They have run that vinyl strip on this B-pillar behind this. And as you can see, actually, our weather stripping is kind of bad. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna get online and make sure that we can get this part. We can still get this seal, get it ordered. Once it gets here, we'll rip this one off. We're gonna actually use that 3M stripper to strip all this. It's gonna have some adhesive behind here, like I said, and we'll strip out the rest of this vinyl strip. But for now, there she is, guys. We'll clean up the windows and stuff when we clean the truck. But, yep. We got it off there finally. We are officially color matched. Not looking forward to tackling the other side. But this thing right here, that is a good investment. That thing is awesome. It made quick work of that adhesive on there. And as you can see at the towards the end, I took that goof off and kind of cleaned the surface with it. That works really well for that. So other than that, that is the process. So we'll jump over to this other side and get started on it. Hopefully now we've learned some tricks to maybe speed up the other side to where it's not so time consuming. And just like that, we are removed and color matched. Looking down the side of this thing, it looks awesome. I love the look. I don't know if it's just the change up, changing the scenery, but I like the look. These dark 5% tinted windows on that color matched B-pillar, awesome. So, looking back on this project, this right here is your best friend in this case. This is your second best friend. Also, I think this is probably between first and second best friend. So, with all three of these tools, you can remove the vinyl strip on your truck, in my case, B-pillar, without any issues. This, all in all, took a couple nights just because I had to go get that 3M adhesive remover tool. I think if I would have had that already in my arsenal, I could have had this done one night. But this is an extreme case, as you've seen. I got kind of got mess on the floor of the crap. I picked up most of it, but this was an extreme case, kind of like what I was talking about in the beginning of the video. It was brittle. It's an O2. Spent a lot of years out in weather, the sun, just baked on there. So we heated it up, got it extremely hot, almost to the point where you couldn't even handle it. Got it peeled off, used our stripping tool, got it stripped clean, goof off, wiped it clean. The only other thing you might want to do, and I will do, is wax that part. With that goof off, it does remove wax, ceramic coatings, anything that you might have on your truck or car. So you would want to take the precautions so you don't expose your paint. And one tip with this, I have seen these burn paint. So do not, I had this drill turned down quite a bit. Didn't turn very fast. It was on just about its lowest setting. You don't need speed for this. It's the abrasive part of the wheel that removes the adhesive. So we got her done. Now we just need a wash. So thanks, guys. Thanks for bearing with me on this video. And if you like this, give me the thumbs up, subscribe, tell your friends, follow me on Instagram, and we'll see you back for the next one.